This video brought to you by Exams A to Z, empowering through education.
Hello everyone. I've seen this problem circulating through many groups, so I've decided to make a video solution of it. And it's very difficult to understand. Please try to follow it carefully. Now look at here. Triangle ABC. Given triangle ABC. And angle B is actually 80 degrees. Angle C is also 80 degrees, which means it's an isosceles triangle. Let me take a copy of it. See here. Just draw a line which is parallel to BC and passing through D. Draw a line which is parallel to BC and passing through D. Now see, this line is parallel to BC and it is also passing through D. Now, it's parallel to BC here. We say if it is 80 degrees, this is also 80 degrees and all. And then next, draw an adjoining line here. Now, let's name it as F. This point is H. Since it's an isosceles triangle, these two sides are same. Even if you draw this DC is same as BF here. And this is 60 degrees means this is also 60 degrees here. So let's copy this also. For the further reference, it will be useful for you. Now look at in this triangle. This angle is 20. This angle is also 20 degrees. Therefore, I can say triangle AFB is isosceles. AFB is an isosceles. Therefore, I can say AF is also is equals to BF. Now, draw a line from A to H. So I'm drawing a line from A to H. Since it's an isosceles triangle, it divides the angle into two equal parts. This is 10 here. Now this is also 10 here. Now look at the triangle BAH. So triangle BAH, if you look at BAH or ABH, this angle is 20 here, this one is 10. Obviously, this is a remaining 150 degrees. And also look at the triangle AEB. AEB. So here AB is same. Look at ABH and ABE. Those two are ABH is congruent to ABE. So, if you look at these two ABH, then after ABE, these two triangles are congruent because in ABE also, the angles are 20, 10, and anyway, this one is 150. And common side is AB. Now the other two sides must be same, right? So I can say BH in ABH it is BH is same as AE. So BH is same as AE. If BH is equals to AE, I should have written it as something like, yeah, BH is same as AE. And we already know that AF is equals to BF. If AF is equals to BF, AF is equals to BF and AE is equals to BH here. If AE is equals to BH, therefore these two sides are also same. So I can say EF is equals to HF. EF is equals to HF. And we already know these two triangles are equilateral triangles. Be it DFH and BHC. These two triangles are equilateral triangle. So in equilateral triangle, all three sides are same. HF is equals to DH. DF. HF is equals to this one, DF. So if HF is equals to DF, I can also say DF is equals to EF. If DF is also EF, now this becomes an isosceles triangle here. If it is an isosceles triangle, and look at the angle over here. Angle over here is 80 because we have drawn a similar triangle, similar parallel line. And these two becomes the corresponding angles 80. So remaining angles is 100. You divide it by 2. So it becomes 50 and 50. And this angle is, it's 70. I can say this angle 70, 80. Remaining angle is 30. Therefore, x plus 30 is equals to half of 100. Half of 100 is 50. Therefore, angle x is equals to 20 degrees. The very tricky part of this is, once again I'm repeating, that is BHA. ABH or BHA is same as EAB. So these two are congruent. So that congruency you have to keep it. So that's all. Thank you.